Hey everyone, Jason here. Today I'm excited to show you my latest Lego creations, which are these gravity-powered walking animals. These are extremely simple mechanical devices that are based off some traditional wooden toys that I stumbled across online one night. So how exactly do these work? We'll take a look at the duck first, which is basically just two hinged parts. The body and the front leg are rigidly connected, and the rear leg is just allowed to swing freely on a hinge. And if we pull the legs out, you can see that it's just basic Technic pin and a couple Technic pieces, and that's all there is to it. So we'll take a closer look at this in action. I can actually take the side of the duck off and put the legs back in. And that way we can see exactly what's going on as it walks. So there are three important aspects to design which make it all work together. The first is the curved feet, which allow the model to rock back and forth, just like a rocking chair. The second is the swinging rear leg. And it's actually important that it's constrained in its path, which is kind of built into the design of the duck. But I'll explain that a little bit more in the kangaroo model. Third is that the center of gravity of the body needs to be at or just above the pivot point on the rear leg, and that's so that when it rocks backwards onto the rear leg, the body can tilt to the back, which actually kicks the front foot forward, and that way when it comes back to the front, it actually takes a step. So when you put it all together, you get this cool little walking motion. So I'll run it again and slow the video down, and that way you can really see what's going on. If we take a look at the kangaroo model, you can see that the legs are on either side of the body, which means there's no built-in constraint to where the legs can swing, and it just doesn't work properly. You need some way to constrain the legs so that the feet get planted in the correct position for it to walk properly. So the way I achieve that is by connecting the rear legs together using this Technic axle. And it is allowed to swing through a gap at the bottom of the body. And that way, the leg swinging is constrained and the animal can walk properly. If you'd like to build either of these models yourself, I have created step-by-step building instructions, which you can find on my website at jkbrickworks.com. I'll add a link in the description and at the end of the video. One note, if you do build them yourself, I am running them on a piece of foam on top of a piece of cardboard, and that is because Lego is extremely slippery. So without a piece of foam or piece of cloth, they'll just slide more than walk down the slope. So that's about all there is to it. I hope you enjoyed these models and the video. Thanks for watching. Keep on building, and I'll see you next time.